marijuana and like my mailbox friends.
Disney's shaking in their boots.
Friend, let's go to the proof of work gym. You can work out, make the ladies pass out.
Did you say make the ladies pass out? That there was not a single lady in the pan. It was just a bunch of dude pros working out. That's crypto for you. Gotta impress the ladies when it's just a circle jerk of a bunch of assholes. Oh, look at him get it.
Get familiarized.
I don't wanna leave.
Yeah, I forgot the song. I'm sure the whole movie of Grease is rolling in its grave right now.
One of my favorite attractions here in Crypto Beach, the micronation of cryptocurrency. Which coin?
ETH.
I'll go with BTC. I'm lightning fast.
He's lightning fast.
Okay, boy, you beat me here, but I sit on the bowl. I'm the king. Run along for your dear life. Make a price go up.
Nakamoto Street, the white paper climb. Show the moon to be honest. Take a drink. Change the garden. Make peace. I'm sorry. What the?
They didn't even set up the song.
Cheers, Cryptofer. The visionary community of Cryptolanders that supported it, those are the real OGs. They quickly understood how powerful creating a physical representation of the metaverse would be. But in retrospect, it was inevitable.
Is that? You finally built the pyramid?
I am inevitable.
Hey, hey, hey.
What the hell is... BitConnect guy got his... his wife didn't even believe in him as much as these dude bros.
Oh no, he's flying away!
I know, Hector stole all your money. If only there was, like, banknotes.
He's dead!
Oh my god, thank you! By the way, I'm Bianca.
Christopher. Nice to meet you again.
I also stole the Superman theme.
Would you like to go for a walk?
Actually,
I guess this sold its purpose
of taking a crypto kitty. Would you mind sharing?
I would love to.
Oh, they don't mean like children. They mean they want to float on inflatable cats.
Vladimir Club's party is about to start.
With children.
As promised, we saved the best for last. See you all there.
Next movie. Yeah, let's talk about Unhinged. Unhinged, the movie that I know is he's road raging. Russell Crowe is road raging. Such a stupid. Oh my god, this movie. I don't think is super self-aware, but it should be. It feels a lot like The Hunt, and I hate that. I think it's a very conservative piece, which I'm not bashing the politics, I couldn't care less. Just sometimes how it speaks in such a matter-of-fact approach with the theme that's very in your face. It treats you like you're stupid and you couldn't get all this. So, our main lady has a kid, has a normal life, I forgot what exactly, but she's just having a bad day. So she honks her horn at Russell Crowe, and Russell Crowe, doing the only sensible thing, that says, I'm going to torment this lady for, I don't know, the rest of the day, the rest of the time, to prove a point. Though, I mean, it's shown in the very opening scene, this guy is a murderer. So who knows what they did to this guy. So, you know, you just messed with the wrong person. And the movie's all about this lack of politeness or civility among people, and it's such a weird angle that, you know, Russell Crowe, who's an established murderer, is just angry because nobody's civil anymore. They just think he's gonna be a good little boy and take it. And that he's not gonna go out and werewolf. Well, he's gonna go out and werewolf, I guess. In Unhinged, Fortnite is referenced more than once and arguably plays a huge role in the plot. I wish I was joking. And it's just, overall, it's a very goofy movie. It's an extremely goofy movie. Whether it wants to acknowledge it or not, Unhinged is a goofy movie. And I think if you're looking for something that is just pure entertainment value, you don't care much about its messages or how it executes the plot. It's just kind of there for silly nonsense to be happening that you can maybe talk over and hang out. It's kind of a good movie for that. I like Unhinged. Not a bad movie. I've seen much worse. I know much worse. Yeah. It's one of those, and it's, a lot of happens. There's some cool set pieces here and there. And we might be in trouble. As there is these purple balloons, just, they ain't popping like they used to. Fine, let's talk about a proc, bro. Fate Apocrypha is okay, I guess. I think it's pretty good. It definitely doesn't feel too much of a downgrade from UFO Table. Being A1 does do the works. It doesn't have as much gloss and shine to it, but that's fine. Apocrypha, I do feel like it could have done more with the premise. You know, it's still mostly one-on-one fighting. It could have been cool to see more combining of abilities. I definitely do think it's staggers a bit in the middle. Definitely some of the character portrayals are more loose on history and get a little funky. But overall, Apocrypha achieves its goal of being a more fun and focused on the Holy Grail War Fate series. It definitely offers a different experience from mainline Fate. Obviously, you know, if you want to get into the weeds, it adds more lore, yada yada yada. That said, I think if it suffers anything, it suffers from falling into some of the pitfalls of romance and convoluted character goals overshadowing all the good stuff, it could balance its cast out a little bit better. But it does have an interesting conclusion. It's not exactly how you think it's gonna end. Ara definitely had certain directions to take the story, and I'm, you know, good on it for finding, you know, a compelling way to end that gives it good action. I think it has a lot of, Apocrypha has good action, even if it's not the most story motivated. The ending has some fan service in it, which I did appreciate. Yeah, Apocrypha, it's fine. It's, yeah, there's just some iffy bits here and there, but not much you can do about it.